sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine, no, I don't remember the next verse, so I gotta give this up. Saved by the Bell.
Synonymous with the Fort Myers Beach music scene than Joe List and Mary Winner. Joe is such a treasure here that she was elected to provide a voice, and she's got a doozy, to the town council, and she didn't even have to sing for her votes. Joe has recorded an album called Natural Girl and performs most every form of music.
Well, I got me a man, he stands 6 feet tall. Shake the paint right off the wall.
As for Mary, she just plays and plays and sings and sings. She's omnipresent here as a regular performer on the deck above the Matanzas restaurant and at Pierside Grill. That Gulf breeze sure complements her relaxing vibe. But when they're together, those two ladies are a tour de force. You see and hear true chemistry when they perform. And they are the island's go-to musicians, whether it be for fundraisers, social events, or even a funeral we recently had for a beloved public official and friend. That shows the measure of respect and trust that this duo commands. Meanwhile, Fort Myers Beach's live music landscape today is as robust as ever. On any given night, this tiny 7-mile island features 20 or more musicians in action. Some of them who live here have even reached national fame. Sheena Brooke was featured as a competitor on the popular The Voice show, while Brian Howe was the singer on several Bad Company albums, one of which went platinum. Beyond the bars and restaurants, several annual events help showcase our local talent. At the Propeller Lounge at Fishtail Marina, we have a winter concert series, and then there's Taste of the Beach in May. Finally, the Island Hopper Songwriter Fest takes place in the fall and moves from Captiva Island to downtown Fort Myers and finally finishes right here on our beach.
So everybody, these are my friends, Joe and Mary, and they are musicians here on Fort Myers Beach. The best of Fort Myers Beach musicians. So I'm going to start with you, Joe, because I probably know you more than I know Mary. But you both answer this. If of all the places that you play right now, what's like the real hot spot?
What's the real hot spot?
Is there a hot spot?
Matanzas.
No, Matanzas, probably.
That's where we've met so many wonderful people. Yeah. That is like the go-to. Yeah. The view's great. and
upstairs.
Yeah, we just love it. The upper deck.
Petey's upper deck.
Yeah, we've met countless friends there, and it's a great place to come together.
And the pizza's fantastic.
The pizza's the best. The pizza's and the best. That's where the first place Mary and I ever sang together.
There?
At Matanzas.
Really? Yeah. So there's a lot of magic that happens up there.
She was playing there one night, and we didn't know each other. We'd heard of each other for years. And then this was at least 10 years ago now, right?
Longer than that.
To be, because I think of you all as being like
interconnected.
Yeah.
Well, I've been there 24 years.
And she was playing.
24 years?
Yeah.
That's why I'm away from home.
Mary's really the soldier in this story.
I know.
She really
is. I know.
But she was singing, and I came up and I said, "Would you mind if I threw a harmony on there with you?" God, I couldn't stand it anymore. She has the kind of voice you just want to sing with.
You just want to sing with, exactly, because it's so strong. And then that's where our magic happens.
And we both were like, whoa, because that's what happens. If you get the right vibrations and stuff and voices together, and our voices, for whatever reason, they just turn
into
another voice of
their own. They melt together. They sure do. Yeah. Oh, so Mary, 24 years at Matanzas.
Yeah.
Holy cow. And when did you start singing on the beach?
Yeah, let's see.
In 1932?
Yeah.
I think I was 18.
It was about
back in the old days.
Back in the day.
Yeah. I didn't know anybody either, so I just came down here and I walked into what is the Shamrock now, but I think it was Gilmore's
or Chauncey's.
Chauncey's.
My friend Ernie Cabral was the bartender there.
That was so long ago. And they just looked at me. I said, I sing and play guitar. And they go, well, let's hear it. So I had this pink dress on and my high heels, city slicker, and came down and showed them what I had. And
where'd you come from, Mary?
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Did you play music there?
Yes.
And so you've been a musician all your life?
Yes, but I've done other jobs, believe me.
Yeah.
I always work. I'm like a bartending at the surf club for 20 years. Hello.
I forgot.
We've spent a couple hours in there.
Oh, Lord.
Hi, Bruce.
Hi, Bruce. Oh, gosh.
Yeah.
Hi, Bruce.
Yeah. And that's another place people used to come in and sing and harmonize to your CD.
Natural
on the jukebox.
Oh, that's what I wanted to ask you. What did it feel like, first of all, to actually cut a CD and then to like see it in a store like mine?
Well,
Local Color.
It's very exciting because it's you know, that particular CD, especially because they're all original songs. They're all songs I've written, and many of them I wrote after I moved here in 95.
Yeah.
So they're relevant to my life on the beach. And so it's very exciting to see that. But I think it's more exciting to see other people enjoying it than to hear it on the radio.
Absolutely.
Or see it in a store. Just to have somebody come up and go, I love your song.
Joe, that's the sign of a true artist. I think every artist loves the viewer or the listener's experience of their work.
Right.
Everyone.
Because for me, I feel most eloquent and able to communicate my feelings through music, even if I'm singing just a harmony to someone else. It's just the way I can express myself freely, and people respond mostly positively
to
it. So.
And she was on that PBS.
That's right.
I heard her singing on PBS. And I'm like, that's Joe.
That's Joe.
Well, it's very different down here, though, because I came from the Boston area and did have quite a career up there. When I came down here, I didn't know anyone, and I was a middle-aged woman then. I wasn't some young chick heading out on the music scene, so it was a little difficult.
Like Mary was in her pink dress.
Like Mary in her pink
dress.
Oh,
so young.
But, I got some years on you both. But anyways, and I got hired to do a commercial for The Best of Everything. You remember that store? The Best of Everything?
Yes.
You remember that? The Best of Everything.
You know, we're calling these videos The Best of Fort Myers.
Okay.
Well, that's so funny.
So this was, and they, now up in Boston, I was in the union, and I made great money doing commercials. That commercial, I got paid less than I would for maybe one gig, and it played for years on the TV and radio, and I was like, oh my God. Oh, it was just unbelievable to me, the difference.
Wow.
But I met
wow.
so many great musicians down here.
Wow. And speaking of performances, you were on the town council for quite a few years.
Yeah, that was a performance.
Was that your swan song, Joe?
Yeah, that was.
Did you ever want to sing a song when you were at the dais?
Oh, yes. I wanted to sing a lot of responses, but, you know, our late mayor, Larry Kuiker,
yes.
He dubbed me the Kumbaya Kid.
That's
and
right.
And he said, and don't be fooled, she has a black belt in Kumbaya. And I wanted to sing Kumbaya so many times. When anybody especially I'm got sure a, maybe emotional yeah. about whatever, yeah. I wanted to get up and sing, Kumbaya, my Lord. You know?
Exactly.
But there were other lyrics that probably yeah. came to mind too, yeah. which I don't want them to come to mind right now.
Oh, please share.
So, well, tell me this. Why do you all think that music is so important on Fort Myers Beach, or it resonates so much, because you go other places and you just don't see the active music scene like you do here. Why is that?
I come from a medical family, and uh-huh. I always thought music is very healing.
Yeah.
And I think that holds true to this day. And even for myself, when I show right. up at the job, it is a comfort. It is my, you know, getting into my mm-hmm. zen mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. we've come this far.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
And I think it makes people feel good.
It does.
And even
it
if
does.
They're having woes, they'll tell you on the side, but they'll sit and enjoy the music and they'll, mm-hmm. they come together. Mm-hmm. It is a good way to come together.
And so. You know, recently both Mary and I have participated in some memorial celebrations and so
yeah.
forth, where music ended up being so key
so
to the comfort
powerful.
And uplifting.
So powerful.
It, and we,
yeah.
you know, it really just goes to show that music is very important for the holistic, you know, existence of a person. There's
I
more
agree.
There's more mm-hmm. than, you know, paying your bills and,
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
money. But to let yourself feel like that and let yourself get carried away on some beautiful idea or
mm-hmm.
sound,
mm-hmm.
yeah, it's very important to the
yeah.
health of a person.
So here on an island, you have all the tranquility of water and sun and sand, and music is a natural addition.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Totally.
Well,
I never thought about it, but that is true, right?
You're about the most right. eloquent person I've
oh,
ever known.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, Joe.
You,
good
I am
Lord.
So happy to listen to you talk about things that are important to you, because you're very eloquent. You say things that people go, oh yes, that's exactly what I meant.
It's exactly what I meant.
Yeah, yeah, you're
not
very,
always, not always.
Well, no, that may be exactly
sometimes.
What they didn't mean, but it's very eloquently.
And you're a businesswoman
nice.
As well. So
yes.
You get your point across.
Yeah, you get your point
how many
across,
stores?
Yes.
Three?
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Thank
I mean,
you, so
you know, how was music important in your family? I mean,
music
did
was
Jose
always
and
important.
Joe like music?
Absolutely. We played, I have a guitar here. I've got a piano. I've played at playing everything, but I was just saying the other day that I am going to pick the guitar back up because I always loved it.
Yay!
I
good idea.
Yeah,
good idea.
So, but I was practicing, and well, that's why I was glad you all walked in, because it was a nightmare. Oh no, there's
practice,
nothing.
Practice.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. So we'll see how that goes. So, girls,
yes.
This has been so great. And maybe just to keep my learn the guitar inspiration going, you guys have another song in you?
Oh yeah, I think we might have something.
Is there one more in the repertoire?
Yeah,
at least one. Yeah,
at least
sure.
one.
Yeah,
at least
all
hi,
right.
Anita, you asked for another song, and we've been working on this a little bit, so let's give it a try.
Okay.
Okay.
One, two, three, four!
Oh, she was here when the town was new, and she knew just what to do for the people who all were living there. They cast their balls for Sarah Cedar. Ooh, and then Anita was the first mayor. As the years rolled by, here came TPI, short-term rental wars, and pipes. Lots of pipe, lots of pipe.
Mama is the man.
believe that.
'Cause you're once, twice, three times the mayor, and we love you. We love you.
I love you too. I can't believe you all got caught. I'm doing this.
Caught? It was fun.
Oh, Lord.